Mheshimiwa tuko hapa na najua jambo nzuri ndio inatuleta pamoja. Ikuagi ni mzuri kupatana saa ile mambo ni mbaya. Na saa hii nadhani tunapambana kwa viwanja tupate wins. Na nadhani na inafurahisha kila mtu mafans wetu pia. Na tukiwin kuna furaha tu na mambo poa hufanyika. So ningependa kurudisha shukrani tena kwa everything yenye unafanyaga club kama patron. Na tunashukuru sana. So on behalf of our wachezaji, ningependa uunganisha hawa kubwa wote. Niko hiyo class na najifunza Kiluya, nishajua nena. Mpaka nimeoa Mluya. So ningependa uunganishe wote. Hii timu kiangalia tuna age poa na tuko na time poa sana ya kurudisha club mali ilikuwa, mali legend wetu waliwacha. Itakuwa poa si tupitie club na tuachi vikombe na tuko na kila kitu inahitajika. So tuna need support yenu pia itakuwa rahisi upande wa motivation. Na hiyo barabara imetujua jina. Tupandishe hata na ndege tunapiga game tunarudi. Tunakushindia mtu najua unaweza.
Leaders who have come, this is a good gesture. I will talk about it. On Sunday I will preach about it so that people will know that we are uniting in small areas. So when we come together united as AFC Leopards, we are going to unite the whole nation. Because I follow AFC Leopards in all their groups. They have groups in Central Province. They have groups, Facebook groups, in Central, Nyanza, in Western, in Nairobi, in Mombasa.
Mimi, bado ni Secretary General of Professional Boxing. Na wewe, mambo yako ni economy policy. Na sports, ndo unajua ina employ my youth wengi dunia mzima. So, kwa hiyo policy tulikuwa tunataka uconsider mambo ya sports. So that hao vijana wakipiga shughuli, at least anajua kienda home, yuko sawa.
So, but when I came into the team, I realized that it is difficult to run this team. It is very difficult, but I thank the chairman and the SG. Together, we quickly realized that we cannot depend on one stream of income. And we quickly put things in motion to ensure that we survive as a club. So as I was mentioning to you, we are very strong now on social media with very limited investments. We have a small shop in town because we understand that merchandise, again, is one area that we can make revenues for us. Partnerships, we quickly, through your leadership chairman, we were able to get BetSafe, who is our main sponsor. And of course, we know that membership drive is one of the other areas that we can make revenues from. So we COVID happened, we had very big plans for membership, but we know we will do it again. So Your Excellency, mine is just to ensure, to assure you that the team led by Shikanda is transparent. We are transparent because we understand that for us to go places, the team must be run in a professional manner.
I'm very happy. We knew Mahmud Abbas Leopards, Ingwe. And I think what I heard, different people from different parts of Africa here today. Now this is pure unity. And I'm glad that sports can join together people, bring people together totally.
It is very disheartening that for 22 years, we have not had a cup. And we are compared badly to our neighbors. Even when you lose the cup, even in the parliament, we are laughed at. And now it is our moment. It's our moment to change the trajectory. It's our moment to have this cup after 22 years. I want to say that it has been a challenge to you players, to the team, the management, mainly because of finances. It has been difficult because I know without proper resource, you can't perform. But I want to thank Honorable Musalia Mudavadi. When he was there 100% those years, that's the time we used to have the cups. And now he has come back 100%. And he has come at the time it is the moment for the Luhya nation. And therefore, we expect that every leader, Luhya leader, Honorable Musalia places a call to support AFC Leopard. We expect them to give an affirmative action. And I'm here to say that being the MP for Musalia Mudavadi, when he goes to State House, I'll be the one in charge of Mululu and also State House. And I want to assure you that AFC Leopards will be the first ones to be given what? Permission to enter Zindio. And the thing you need to do now, and which I want to beg you and request you, expand your networks. I'm glad to hear that you have 6 million followers. If we convert 80% of those followers into votes in 2022 for the president, you can see how far we'll be.
AFC is very close to my heart, as you all know. Tumekuwa na nyinyi. I worked closer with the previous committee. And I made a mistake because yesterday when His Excellency was announcing me as patron, I thought I am the former patron. Because every new leadership structure always brings its own, appoints a patron. But with Musalia here, I can only be his deputy, assistant, sub-patron. Because you're the real guy. You know, and na mimi ni kijana wako mkono. So whenever you don't find him, I am always there. And whatever I do it in his name for our team. We've walked a long journey, and the struggles you've discussed, you understand how it has been. I did my best, but I have not finished. I'm still there. In fact, I'm very happy to see. Where is Rupia? Ako wapi? He will tell you the story of how I first tried to sign him. Tukakutana Palasina. Unakumbuka? Tukua kijana mdogo, ulikuwa unacheza catch. Because I knew this boy had the spirit of Masiga and Kadenge combined. In one. Sasa umekuja zaile siko, lakini bado niko. Tuendelea pamoja. And all of you, I'm very proud of what you're doing. I was excited. Normally when we win Muringia, watu sishikiki. Siezi shikwa. Last week na Sharks, I was so excited. It was 2-0, wasn't it? I was very excited that we defeated them. I sent Nick Mwendo a message. Nikamwambia tulia bado. Utaona, AFC is back. But I want to encourage you. Because I know it is very difficult for you. Especially for the players. I know it's not easy. You guys are friends when you want to choose team zingine. Sazingine mnaona wako fiti, mnaishi nao place moja. Nyi mmeshinda, haujapata allowance, haujapata nini. It's tough on you. Do not be discouraged. We have a lot of goodwill. And that's why, Chairman, thank you for calling this meeting and Your Excellency. Because unless we harness the goodwill and translate it into something, we will just be talking. And talking will not pay your rent. Talking will not give food, put food on your table, will not raise our training standards. Kuka, you'll tell them, when I was your patron of boxing, the corners we had to go at KPBC to get support. Last time when SportPesa withdrew, when they were having issues, we had to go and tukakana nani, my friend Ronald, and they gave us 65, was it 65 million shillings as a team. Now we have 35. It is not enough. It is nowhere close to enough. We have many people that we can... You know, this is one of the clubs where, and not just people from Western, across the country. I can tell you the biggest supporter of AFC, for instance, in the Senate, is Mutula Kilonzo. And he's a member. And he always asks me, where's the latest jersey? Where's the latest jersey? Across the country and across the continent, there's a rich history. But now what you need to do is to translate that. Yeah? Tukae hata na professionals wa marketing na kuuza. We translate that goodwill into resources. Western is the first place you've spoken about, of course, the counties. I need to figure out how that can be done within the PFM law, but where there's a will, there's a way. But in Western, we agree. There are two things we can never disagree about. Our people might have different opinions on many things, but the two things we are agreed on, in fact, there are three. Of course, the first is Ingoho. There's never a debate between two lawyers on chicken. We can have a debate. The second is AFC Leopards, and the third is Musalia Mudavadi. Isn't it? Yeah. Those are the three things that there's no debate. So now, Nimesikia AFC and see what not. Let us use that goodwill. Let us start home, and then let's talk to our friends. The other day when I was with you, I told you, we sat. People like Bidco are interested. It's just for us to go and present to them. You know, and you can be creative. You know, someone is a shirt sponsor, mwingine anashikilia pande nyingine na nini, and count on us. So for the Harambee, we shall be there. But I've always felt, and I know many people may not like it, I've always felt that is not the sustainable way. Inaziba tu shida kidogo kidogo, temporarily. But a sustainable way is how to make the club profitable. And let us invest. There are people who would put money in a name that sells. They'd put money into it. So in as much as kuna sentimental attachments, we must now think 21st century. This is not AFC when my dad was treasurer in the 70s and 80s of AFC. It is not the same. This is a different time. And with this time, there's resources. Watu wako na chapa, and people enjoy the game. So I am available, and I want to acknowledge you. I am available on behalf of our real patron to be there for any strategy meeting, to bring in the networks I have, which are still there. Now wako na chapa pia, bado hawajasota, for us to translate it into AFC. Now, mwaka hii jameni, can we agree we are number 4 right now, isn't it? Two games in hand. Tutakuwa juu ya meza ama itakuwaje? You know, me, I want to hear the commitment from you. Sijui mnataka sisi to commit kwenu. But we also need a commitment from you. So that it's a contract. That I'm doing this because this is what you're giving us in return. And in return, this is what we are doing. Can we get a commitment to be on the top of the table na kushinda kuchukua kikombe? Is that a commitment? Wangapi wanaku? You don't sound convincing. Is that our commitment? AFC itakuwa wapi? Juu ya meza. Sawa sawa. So you can count on us. Let me not say much more because I came last.
I would like my players to know, and my technical bench, and everybody in this room, that AFC Leopards is not only a football club, but it is a force that can make a greatest change in your life. If you believe in the badge. I played for AFC in the 80s for 5 years. We won 3 trophies. And I remember I was somewhere in South Africa for an interview. And 2 people in that panel knew me through AFC Leopards. And I got that job in South Africa. It's been a tough journey. And I'm happy Enos has mentioned part of the tough journey, especially last year was impossible. I came in first as rescue. That time we were sincerely going to the grass. I thank Senator Sakaja. He really helped us that time. And we managed to escape relegation. Come elections, we were elected. And I thank some of the technocrats in AFC Leopards who changed our constitution to have 3 officials. I am sure if we had 10 officials in AFC Leopards by now, the club could not have been there as we speak. It's been a journey. I thank my colleague, Treasurer, Secretary, sorry, had to go back to work. It's been tough. I thank Chichi so much. He stood as a man together with my secretary. At times, and a good story is about BetSafe. Your Excellency, BetSafe were to sponsor, in fact, they were to pay our salaries in December last year, before Corona. December last year, 2019. No, not even last year, 2019. And I brought BetSafe in this country. And I remember the first time I met them, I entered a room, somehow half of this place. It had 12 wazungus. And my mission was to market Kenyan football because they wanted to go either to Tanzania or Zambia to give them reason why they should invest in Kenya. There were 12 wazungus. Wajuaji videti. They had spoken to Rachier, and they were not convinced. So I was the last person they met. They only met 2 people, myself and Rachier. We were at Palasina, top floor, 7th floor. And they told me, I have 30 minutes to convince them whether to invest in Kenya or to go. I did veterinary medicine. I thank God I did it in English. Niliongea kizungu yote ikaisha. But as we went along, I gave them reasons why they should invest in this country and why AFC Leopards is key to them. So after all that, they were convinced. It was somewhere in November. And they told me, to show you our commitment, how much is your wage bill? I told them. They told me, December salary, I'm paying. Your Excellency, I came to my players, they had not been paid for 2 months. I told them, salary at December iko. I don't know what happened. It didn't happen. That December didn't happen. Again, they told me January. That January didn't happen. Again, they were to do it now in March. Then as they were to do it in March, remember Corona started in Europe. They were hit so hard in Malta that now they called off everything. So we remained with these boys. There's no sponsor. There's nothing. And you have a family of 50, you cannot pay salaries. Just imagine you have 3-4 boys, the way they can harass you. Now a family of 50. But I thank God, together with my team and Enos, we decided to knock each and every door. Na tuligonga hizo milango. And FC being a big club, all those doors, we got audience. Na wengine wetu kitusikiza kidogo, something will happen. I thank Fwamba. We worked with him. Maybe just stand up a bit, wakuone. We worked with him for about 2 weeks. Although we didn't get anything, but he opened for us some doors. And we shall revisit those doors because they are potential doors to make sure that these players, Your Excellency, are paid well. At the moment, we are not very good, and I believe they need to be paid better than they are being paid now. We are still working on that. And because it's not my day, there's one thing I want to tell you. It was like a dream when I discussed with Enos and we asked ourselves, which door haven't we knocked? We said State House. And he said, can we try State House? And yes, we said, let us try. We knocked the State House door. And thank God it opened. And since that day, I believed whatever you believe in can happen. And now, my sons and my brothers, the technical bench. In fact, I honor the technical bench. This is a group, I can say, the players have benefited a bit from this office in terms of maybe their salaries being paid, especially the time of Corona when they were not playing. But we are indebted so much to the technical bench. They have worked under serious conditions and they've stood with us. So what I'd like to tell my teammates, my players, my brothers, and everyone, this team is a special team. Especially now, if we can win the league and the people will win the league for this team after that 22 years, I promise, after opening all those doors, and we are praying, it's an important day for us. That's why we have His Excellency here, because we do not want any debate elsewhere that who is the leader of Luyas and hence the leader of this country. This is the unifying factor of first the Luya land. The reasons why FC was formed, number one, to unite all the Luyas. Number two, to unite this country. And that's why you can see there are all forms of players in this team from each and every tribe, from each and every region. So gentlemen, my promise is this. I know at times you said, uche wa muongo na danganyanga, but I want to give you a promise. I gave a promise of salaries and it came to pass. And I know we have not stabilized. I love making history. I've made some history in this football. I've made some history in areas that I've worked in. Win this league, especially this year and next year. And each person will go home with a house. I have these brothers here. And it is not a joke. If you don't own a house in Nairobi, win the league for FC Leopards. I have a reason why I'm saying this. If you feel it's a joke, well and good. If you think it's serious, win it and throw it to me. And Enos and Chichi and Sikuku. There's something we know that you do not know. So, we know we will be given 5 million if we win the league by BetKing. That 5 million, first of all, you'll share it. But our prize as AFC Leopards and all the people in front here are AFC Leopards and others are not in this room. The current head of state is a supporter of AFC Leopards. His mother is a supporter of AFC Leopards. In fact, he has given AFC some assets before. I can tell you for free, win the league when the iron is still hot. When there is this debate of who becomes the next president. And I can assure you, you will be given a house. Your house. Ochan, hata kama utabeba uende nayo Uganda, itakuwa yako. Sawa sawa. Fabrice, unanisikia? Najua yuko na hizo mavitu. Fabrice, tunataka league. Unajua league? Zawadi gani kubwa ushapewa kwa kushinda kitu yoyote? Gari. Sasa sisi tutakupatia nyumba. Na chairman amesema leo, andika chini. Shaka, zawadi gani kubwa ushapewa? Gari tu. Sisi tutakupatia nyumba. Gentlemen, I am serious about this. And the people we have, the people who have been telling us about FC Leopards, are serious with this club. We are trying to give a direction, and we want, after 56 years, we want to have our training ground, we want to have our clubhouse, and they will happen if you give us results on the pitch. And everybody we are discussing with want that to happen. And your ultimate prize, I repeat for the last time, will be a house. For the 30 of you, will be on that squad to win the league. Coaches, I know it has been difficult. At times, the victory of sports is ours. At times, we have it hard accessing Kasarani or Nyayo Stadium. We'd also want you to talk to your sister in charge of that ministry. First and foremost, if they can allow at least 3,000 fans back to the stadium, it can be good for us. It will give us some easy money to actually run the team, because if I have 3,000 fans in the stadium, that is 6 million. Somebody, 600,000, somebody has given me 600,000. So we would like to have some fans in the stadium. And being a big team with fans back, it will push them. And then on 12th, as we've mentioned, we'll have a function. And the objective of that function is to try and finish sign on fee, also try and get some insurance for these players. It's unfortunate, maybe other people will think it's a failure on our part. Our players don't have an insurance cover, which is very risky. So we just attend to anything that comes in. We try and mitigate. You pay the hospital bills then, but I think that's very risky. We would like them to have an insurance cover. And also this thing of salaries. I know with our strategic plan, which will be launching on the 12th, it will help us start generating some money. I talked to Senator Sakaja. I am finishing the proposal. Our people are consumers. And I am sure if we talk to Bidco and they give us a line on their oil, like they have Golden Fry, if we can have an Ingwe Fry, I am sure it will sell in Western, and the little money we'll get from that will help us take care of these boys.
The chairman of AFC Leopards and his management team, the players, the bench, the supporters, the fans, and even the opponents. And of course, our patron, the Senator Sakaja, Super Senator Sakaja, and the spiritual pastor who makes sure that you're not just physically fit, but you're also in the right frame of mind spiritually. So I want to thank you for being here this afternoon so that we can enjoy lunch together. And we look forward to victory after this. AFC Leopards, as somebody said, is it's a tradition. You know, it symbolizes tradition. It symbolizes a culture. You know, a culture of fortitude, a culture of resilience, a culture of vibrancy. That is what AFC Leopards is all about. Courage. Ingwe. The hunter. No, this is what AFC Leopard is. And as a tradition, it carries the aspirations of so many people. As somebody said, some of our relatives, when they go out and they're watching the game, and somebody says, what happened? Others can't eat supper on that day because they have lost. Others cannot do other things because they have lost. But you will find that when there's victory, there's a lot of excitement. So you carry the spirit of so many things. You carry the spirit of the nation. And this is what we are here to celebrate. So I just want to give you one or two assurances. First, that on the 12th, we shall be together when the fundraising is in place, and we shall do the lobbying in advance so that we can help get as many people to come and support you on the 12th. The second thing that I want to say is that we embarked on a journey when you came to see me at the MM Center, and we said that the land that was given to you at that time, you are looking for the stand premium of 600,000, which we fulfilled. And now there's some additional consequential expenditures which the Ministry of Lands requires, which come to about 700,000. I just want to tell you that by the time we reach the Harambe of 12th, we shall have settled the 700,000. So that you can proceed in the pursuit of your residence, your permanent home. To me, that is so important for this team. It's a legacy that you will leave, so that money is paid to the lands office. Now they process the deed plans and everything. Then the rest shall be how we can now work towards developing the 20 acres that belongs to AFC Leopards. To me, this is so significant. When you are self-sufficient, when you have your own premises, when you have your own asset, then you start changing the thoughts of everybody. I had the captain talk and say that they want to have something in their hands as a victory. And they're getting restless because 22 years have elapsed and these trophies have been running away. So he was saying time is catching up with them. Wataanza kukua coaches na kuingia kwa technical bench. So they are urging that the blood is bubbling. They want to win. Let us be part of your victory. And Mr. Chairman, as you are talking, you did say something about the need to help the football clubs to start becoming self-sustaining again. Luckily, our patron is the chairman of the Labour and Social Welfare Committee at the Senate. And you have raised a good point that now that we have seen protocols around the COVID improving systematically, there's actually merit in your proposal that perhaps the Ministry of Health, together with the Ministry of Sports and the relevant committees, can and indeed should start facilitating at least up to, say, the 3,000 fans or spectators in the stadia for each team, because then that will give you some reasonable amount which can at least pay maybe the allowances of the players at any one time, rather than this idea of keeping everybody out and it's straining all people. If they can allow that, if Nyayo Stadium has got a capacity of what, 20,000, 18,000. So even if you are playing your arch rivals, Gor Mahia, they have their 3,000 fans, you have their 3,000 fans, surely 6,000 people in Nyayo Stadium, there would be sufficient spacing that would allow that protocols around the coronavirus do not deter fans beginning to start seeing a bit of soccer. In order to get everybody back on their feet, including the sporting fraternity, I think these are measures that we should start looking at carefully. After all, people are asking, I'm not saying that two wrongs make a right, but people are asking that tunaona politicians wameanza kuzurura in areas where there's no iota of COVID protocols. Wanarundikana kama kitu kingine, wakizurura kwa mambo yao ya siasa, to the extent that you wonder, is the risk higher there, or is it possible to now open up systematically for some of the players so that they can survive? So I think this we can do. And finally, just to tell you, be strong. You have gone through difficult times. Sometimes you, vile umesema, you go hungry. Munaenda bila kulala vizuri. Vumilia tu. Nyinyi ndio mnaweka msingi wa wale watakuja baadaye. Because Rome was never built in a day. But the fact that you are able to show perseverance, and it makes you a better person in future. Nothing comes easy. Even in your own personal life later, nothing comes easy. So when you go through some challenges, it only prepares you for even bigger challenges. Kwa hivyo, mujikaze. Mimi nimekuwa mtu wa AFC kwa muda mrefu sana. I was also a patron. My father was a patron. The only thing I never did for AFC was to play for them. that I did not do. But in terms of encouraging and supporting, I've always been somebody close to AFC. The only time that I was away from AFC, I told Dan Shikanda that, at least for the older ones, who might remember that the first professional football club in Kenya, which was called Volcano United, I was one of the founder members of Volcano United at that time, with Joe Kadenge Senior, the late, Jerry Saura. Of course, I was there. And we had a sponsor. We managed to get sponsors from Japan at that time. So we put up a very good professional team. And at that time, the Federation managing football, walikuwa na siasa yao. So when Volcano came, it became such a good team. And it started beating the big boys. My friend, FKF, walivunjilia hiyo team mbali. They dismantled it because they said, mnaingiza mambo ingine ambayo hayatakikani kwa mpira wakati huo. But subsequently, of course, the professionalism has started coming in. But I'll tell you one thing. At that time, in 1987, when there was the All Africa Games tournament here, believe you me, the national team, the Kenya national team that played there. And I think that was the perhaps the highest level of we had ever reached in that Africa tournament. Do you know Volcano produced 5 of the players that were in the national team? As far back as that. So I'm a sportsman. I like the sports. I would like sports not just to be there for entertainment, but sports must become a livelihood for our young people. It must become a livelihood. It must become a serious source of income. And as we go forward, we must look at all policy issues that are an obstacle to sports. Sometimes the taxation structure that is pushed to sports does not make sense. These are issues that we need to look at. How do we help grow sports? Whether it is soccer, whether it is rugby, whether it is athletics, sometimes you end up punishing your own people. We must think seriously. I mean, why do we get our sportsmen running away to go and compete for other countries? Yes, there must be something. The earnings are better that side. Why don't we figure out how to sort out these things? And I know we can. Tukikana vijana kama nyinyi na senators kama wakina Sakaja hawa and many other young people, wakina Dan Shikanda, young leadership that is coming, we can make sports extremely lucrative and make it a big industry for this country. If you say you want to generate employment, then we must seriously look at sports. Let's create the proper framework to make sports make the difference. If I'm a policy maker, let's look critically at that. Let me not bring you a wheelbarrow. Let us look at the policy framework that can make and have a serious multiplier effect from sports. It can be done. And it's just a question of the right policies, the right incentives. And we change the lives of millions of young people. So let me end there because we'll have another opportunity. So Dan, Chairman and your team, congratulations for holding out up to this time. And you'll have to hold out even longer. And we look forward to the 12th. And thank you for coming for the lunch. Thank you to our friends from Mombasa who have also joined us and supported us in this. Thank you so much for being here. And I can tell you, AFC is unstoppable. You are, as I said, an embodiment of a culture, an embodiment of a tradition. Traditions don't disappear. Cultures don't disappear. God bless you all.